everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm going to teach you how to cook. Tonight I'm making a slow cooker recipe that is going to be so delicious when I wake up tomorrow. It's corned beef with cabbage. Oh yeah, you don't have to brine it for 5 or 6 days. I'm going to show you how to do it in a slow cooker and it's going to be so good. That's the show today and I want to share it with you, so let's get going because I want to go to bed and this is Eating in Bed. It's actually nighttime right now and I'm heading to bed pretty soon, but I wanted to make something that's gonna be ready for lunch tomorrow or dinner. And even though March has rolled us by and usually this is associated with St. Patrick's Day, I decided to make some corned beef in the slow cooker. It's a really easy recipe and I'm actually starting it late at night. I'm gonna let it cook overnight and then get it in the morning, check on it. The whole house is going to smell like meat all night long, but it's not a bad thing. So let me show you some of the things that I've put together already. This is a really simple recipe. I have a big slow cooker. This is about a 5-quart size. I have a smaller one that I've used before, but this one is about a 5-quart size. So you're going to need a little bit of space for this, but let me show you some of the vegetables. I'll show you the meat and we're going to get this together. It's really simple. You're really going to like this. So first off, I've started with 1.5 pounds of red potatoes. You don't even have to peel them. These are great little potatoes. You don't want them too big. If there's any huge ones in your bag, use them for something else and just use small ones. And you're going to cut them long ways. You want to cut them crossways. You don't want to cut them long ways. So find which way it's kind of oval right there and then cut across it. And that's it. 1.5 pounds of red potatoes. Really super easy. Also 1 pound of carrots, and I've cut them crossways as well. Just run them under some cold water, wash them off a little bit. And lastly, I have 1 head of cabbage. Now I only need about 1.25 pounds to 1.5 pounds of cabbage. What you want to do is cut from the top down into the core so it holds together. You're going to have a couple of stray leaves here, but you should do about 1-inch section just like this. Here's another one here. This was a weird corner piece, but cut from the core down. Don't cut crossways on this. Here's pretty much 1/2 a head here. This big leaf. We can get rid of that, actually. And then just take it and cut from the core, right through the core, straight down through your cabbage like this. So you have little kind of wedges is what you're going for. About 1 inch wide or so, give or take. You don't want them too big. But you don't want them too small because you want them to hold up in the cooking process. And now for the brisket. You want about 3.5 to 4 pound size, and you can usually find them packaged just like this. This is about 3¾ pounds. It is just right. You can buy pickling spices, but luckily for us, this comes with exactly what we need. We need about 1 tablespoon of pickling spice. Pickling spice is pretty strong stuff, so you don't need a lot of it. If your brisket has a lot of fat on it, cut it down to where it's about 1/8 to 1/4 inch. This one is pretty well trimmed, and I think I'm just gonna leave it the way it is. There's a little bit right here you could take off if you wanted to, but I mean, that's getting pretty close to the meat. And fat adds flavor. You don't want a lot in there, but it's adding flavor. Now you want to start with a cold, slow cooker. And like I said, I have about 5-quart one here. If you have one that's about 3.5-4 quarts, you should be okay with that, but I like a little bit more room for this. So I'm gonna put the meat right in here first. You're just gonna put it right in there. You can put the fat side down or the fat side up. I don't think it really matters. And next up, you're gonna start tucking the carrots and the potatoes down by the sides of the beef. So, I mean, this is a pretty good fit in here. So I'm just gonna put them around the edges. If you have a little space, you can pull it back like this. Put a little bit of carrot in there. You know, with the pointy end, you can kind of poke down in there pretty easily, just like that. And of course, the potatoes as well. Even raw, this meat really does smell good. I can only imagine what this is going to smell like after cooking. Lastly to this, add your cabbage wedges. Just set them right over the top, just like this. That already looks good. I think I'm glad I used the 5-quart size here because I'm gonna need every bit of it. Now, you do need a little bit of liquid, so 6 cups of water. But first, cut open your seasoning packet and just all over the top, right down in there, just like that. And if you want, you know, you can move some of this cabbage and let some of that spice mix fall down there so it hits the meat, just like that. But like a little bit on top too. And then add your 6 cups of water. So I've got a 2-cup measure that's going right in. And then a 4-cup measure for 6 cups total. It's gonna fill it up. That's nice. Okay, so 6 cups of water, and put the last little bit of cabbage in there because you don't wanna waste it. Put your lid on. This is going to cook about 6 to 7 hours on high, about 8 to 9 hours on low. And that's what I'm gonna do. Put it on the counter, plug it in. It's not gonna boil over or anything like that. I'm gonna do low for about 8.5, 9 hours. When we come back from the break, this is going to be later. It's going to be the next day. The whole house is gonna smell like meat. The cats are gonna be going crazy. It's gonna be really good. But I'm gonna show you what this looks like and how to serve it up. Okay, so I'll catch you right after the break. I'm not even doing an extra helping today. I just wanna cook some corned beef, and it's really that delicious. So let's take a break. I'm going to bed. I will see you tomorrow after the break, and I think you're gonna like this corned beef. Stay tuned, I'll see you right after this.
Use Reynolds Wrap to freeze. Fights freezer burn, you're gonna learn how Reynolds Wrap can freeze. Takes the cold, takes the heat, from casseroles to dinner meat. Use Reynolds Wrap to freeze. What Reynolds Wrap can do, protects your buys, no wonder why you're gonna take this cue. When you cook a batch, get a catch to freeze a lot, just keep this thought. Use Reynolds Wrap to freeze.
Now you'll find freezer labels in specially marked boxes of heavy-duty Reynolds Wrap aluminum foil.
One reason why Duracell batteries last so long is because we're always improving them. In fact, today's Duracell batteries will last up to 20% longer than the ones we made just 3 years ago. To do it any other way would be, well, the tail wagging the dog. Duracell, the copper top battery. When it comes to making them last longer, we never stop.
Okay, it has been 9 hours. It is the next day. It's beautiful outside, a little chilly, but it's great today. And I am so excited to show you this. 9 hours. And then I actually turned the crock pot off and pulled the crock out of it and just let it set here for a few minutes. Let me show you what's going on here. It's still a little warm. Look at that. That cabbage is nice and tender on top. Now what you want to do, let's get the vegetables out of here first, and then I'm going to show you what to do with the meat. So just with a pair of tongs, you can pull all the vegetables out, or spoon them out, you know, whatever. Pull them out. Be careful so the cabbage doesn't break apart. Some people want maybe a whole section of cabbage here. And you're going to pull all this out and just plate it to the side. You can actually, once you get the meat out of here, you can put this back in the slow cooker if you want to. But we can leave it here and we can just cover it with a bit of foil or something like that. Look at these potatoes. I mean, come on. Look at that. Or sorry, those are carrots. I know what vegetables are what. Here's the potatoes though. They're still whole. You know, they slow cooked. You can see around the edge here, there's a little bit of brown where they started to cook. Oh, and they're nice and tender right in the middle. Kind of plate these up nicely. Okay, so we have the vegetables out. We can just set those to the side. They are going to stay warm. So I'm gonna push them right back here out of the way. I've got my great serving platter. Thank you, Home Goods. And gonna get this meat out. I tell you what, it's a little bit of a monster. It was a big piece of brisket in there. Oop, there's still a few potatoes hiding under there too. But let this drain off for a minute. Mmm, Look at that, just a huge piece of corned beef. I love that little piece hanging on for dear life right there. Still had some carrots hiding out. Now you really want this meat to set for a little bit, like you do any piece of meat. So I got a piece of foil here that I have, and I'm just gonna cover this really well and let it sit for about 15 minutes. You really want that to kind of just, the juices to come together. You don't want to cut into it just yet. Okay, so it's been 15 minutes. It's really important to let that rest. Now, here's the meat. I know it doesn't, I tell you, sometimes just looking at meat, it's like, really? Yeah, really. Now, let me set this to the side. I get the tongs. I'm gonna show you how to cut this. In case you don't know, I know a lot of you do, but you can see that the grain of the meat goes this way. And normally you would cut with the grain on a piece of roast beef or something like that. But in this case with corned beef, you wanna cut against the grain. This is, look at, there's that fat back on the bottom of it. Ooh, you can take that off if you want to. See how that just slides right off? That added some flavor and it softened up, maybe a little bit rendered down in there, and you can just take that fat right off of there. It's really not much. You could leave it if you wanted to, but that's all right. So normally you would cut with the grain, but on corned beef, you cut against the grain. So you can see the grain going this way, and we're gonna cut, oh, that is really tender too. Still has a little bit of body to it. That is nice. Those pickling spices are just really nice. They're intense flavor for the brisket. But in general, it just all kind of mellows out and comes together. Now I've got my vegetables back here, so let's take that potato that we bit into already. And I'm gonna get a carrot, maybe a little bit of cabbage, right? I mean, that's the whole point, corned beef and cabbage. Oh, I'll take it. Okay, girl, hold on, there you go. And then a couple pieces of meat right there. I'm gonna put this whole piece of meat right in my mouth. That is so tasty. It almost has a buttery consistency about it. Just this really smooth consistency. We know that these potatoes and carrots are wonderful. And now that cabbage. So nice. It really is delicious. You can't go wrong with corned beef and cabbage. So I'm gonna get this carved up and ready because we're gonna have lunch around here pretty soon. Give the video a thumbs up, click that like button. Whether you've had corned beef or not, let me know in the comments below and your favorite little extra nuance to add to something. Be sure to click the subscribe button so you don't miss anything from us. And I will see you next time. I'm gonna go enjoy the corned beef and cabbage. Thank you for watching, I appreciate it. I'll see you next time, bye. First off, in our crock pot, don't turn the crock pot on yet. Start with a cold crock pot. Okay, start with a slow, what is it? Start with a cold, okay, start with a cold slow cooker.